There's no doubt in my mind he wanted to put Susan Rice in the National Security Advisor job at some point.
Right.
The surprise was that he did it now, and that he did it just a few days before the summit meeting with the Chinese leader, which Tom Donilon had served as point man right. to set up. So
even more than that, he was a point man on China, period.
He was a point man on China, period, but he set up the summit, too. So to yank him right on the eve of that summit really was kind of odd. It was prefigured in a way by a piece in Foreign Policy magazine a couple weeks ago by Jim Mann, where there were a few quotes in there from the new chief of staff, Dennis McDonough, who had been Tom Donilon's
deputy,
where he sort of damned Tom by faint praise, saying he performed of value to the president's foreign policy, and they got along as well as two Irishmen could get along. And as soon as you saw that from the new chief of staff, you knew that something was going to happen. But it is a surprise as of now.
So when you look at what this means for foreign policy, does Susan Rice bring different skills that will impact on presidential decisions?
Yes, and that's what I have tried to think about, to talk to people about today. Susan Rice, first of all, is very close personally to the president. It's almost like his kid sister was being appointed National Security Advisor. I always think when I see her, where she's so voluble, so direct and frank, that she's saying the things that Barack Obama would say if he was less a reticent man, if he was more open and more of an extrovert. So I think it's going to be useful to have somebody who really knows the president's mind and can speak for him, both in the interagency process and to some extent to other world leaders. I also think that Susan Rice is more of a policy intellectual than Tom Donilon was. Tom was a great process man. He wanted to think strategically. The president said of him today that he was both a strategist and a tactician, but it was really the latter, the tactical side, that I think the world saw. Susan Rice has a chance to channel the strategic side of Barack Obama in these remaining 3 years. Obama has, I think, a systematic critique of how America's role in this changing world should how we should play our hand. He hasn't been able to articulate it very well, except for a few speeches.
Okay.